22, 23. So that's 23 pillars we're going up. Okay, so, okay, here we go. Woo! Greetings, guys and girls and fellow gamers. My name is Games2Kicks and welcome back to 7 Days to Die Alpha 15. In the last episode, we had a lot of explosions and we brought down the house, well, on one side anyway. Now, I don't probably have enough time to actually get the other side collapsed, but what we're gonna do is we want to use this area here for the next horde. So I'm gonna close everything off. I'm going to make all the required metal spikes. And then we're gonna upgrade them. So what we're going to have to do is we're gonna have to go around here. Here. And then we're going... I'm gonna count them up now before we start. And then we're gonna get this shark tank going as well as all the spikes. I think that that's what we have time for. So if we actually end up having the horde here, at least nothing will come into our shark tank. And they should all fall down here. So we should be able to do it. Anyway... I hope you're gonna be enjoying the episode. If you do, remember to kick that like button in the balls to support the channel and the series. And if you're new to the channel and you like what you see, hit that subscribe button. So let's get started building the shark tank. The first thing we're gonna have to focus on is putting all these support beams down. Oh, look at all that iron. Oh, man. So we have them about three apart. The only reason there's more space in here in the middle is because that is the actual centerpiece here. So, and we had to put the ladder up. So it's actually exactly in the middle. So one, two, three, four. And then here we have one, two, three, and then one, two, three to the wall. Excellent. So because it is seven, so we're gonna do the same here. It's one, two, three, and then pow. So let me do that again. One, two, three, boom. There we go. One, two, three, excellent. And that means we don't have any problems with the support of anything. And if something comes crashing down, we don't have to worry about it too much. Okay, so that's the right height. How many is there? Oh, damn it. I keep forgetting because my leg is sprained, is splinted. I take damage actually very easily when I'm jumping down now. So one, two, three, four, five. Excellent. All right, so we're going to put these all the way around. And then we're gonna upgrade them. I have loads and loads of resources. I'm also building a lot more of these guys. So we should have enough, hopefully, to get started. Oh, I probably should queue up some spikes as well. In total, for the whole surface, we need 438 approximately. So I'm gonna queue up 450 spikes. Luckily, I drained a lot of iron out of these over the last couple of episodes. Not the last couple of episodes, all the time. So we need about 17,000. So, oh, wow. Okay, so we have just about enough. So we better actually get more iron burnt and more iron extracted. So if we have 450, is that what we need? Let me see. Recipes. Just put the spikes in. Oh. Yeah, there we go. We have just about enough. 450, holy balls. That is a lot. Now, what we also want to do at the same time is we want to start 1, 2, 1, 2. Excellent stuff. So we want to put these guys in here and start extracting the iron we have actually in them for the moment as well. So this is 500 burns at 43 minutes. So that is 86 minutes. Okay, let's upgrade these guys. There we go. Very nice. Love it. Very fast. And then we're gonna put the quarter blocks up. And I think by that time then, our spikes should be finished. And we should be able to put them down. And all we have to do then is put the pillars up and upgrade them as well. There we go. Nice. Love it. Excellent stuff. And then there will be more over on that side, but we're probably not gonna have time to get this done. So, I mean, there's only three blocks actually that we have to go in here. So bringing this down is gonna be straightforward. We're just gonna literally dig out everything as we did over there, but then we're just gonna dig underneath to bring it down instead of TNT. So we keep it quieter than the TNT. Is there anything else that we need to upgrade? No, that's all done. Very good. Like it. I think we have just about enough. No, we're not. Actually, I forgot about this side. Oh, man. Am I crafting anymore? 66. That actually might be enough. I can always make more. Like, I think, though, that this is my last concrete mix. So I have to be very careful. We definitely want to upgrade all of these guys. And if I can make enough steel, if everything is burning correctly and I can make enough steel, I want to also upgrade the things up here to steal these circles, because the shark tank is our last safety net. If they breach the shark tank, we're screwed. Then we have to go downstairs and have to kill them from below, which means we have to upgrade all these guys as well properly. Wow, that's a lot of upgrading. So let's there we go. Nice. Look at that. I love when the plan comes together. This is amazing. Oh, man. This is going to be so cool. We're going to get this ready for Hort Night. Hort is going to be dropping down, and they're going to be all... We can actually make them die, literally, on drop down, except for the toughest sons of bitches, which is the cops and the ferals. But in general, I think we can get everybody to die. Now, I'd rather get experience, but I think I would rather let them die and loot them. Because I'm not really too worried about experience. And the big guys that don't die, they give enough experience by themselves, I think. Anyway, we'll see how we're gonna get on. I totally forgot I actually made more sand. Holy balls. Because of all the stone we got from the... from taking out the... Whatchamacallit? From taking out the big chunk of rock. That's... Oh, man. I totally forgot about that, which is great. I had another 1,000 concrete mix in each of those. So what we're going to do now is we're going to queue up a little bit more concrete mix. So 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Excellent. So that's going to be here, 2,000. And then we're going to do the same for the other side. 1, 2, 3, 4. Always do double the stone, then cement and sand. There we go. Excellent. And another 2,000 queued up. Beautiful. So we're gonna go back now. I think we have enough. I got some decayed bricks, which I had queued up a while ago. I just took them out of here. This is my decayed brick makers. They have the stone and the clay in here, so I always can make decayed brick. How is our iron getting on? 3,800 and going. Very good. And 3,800 and going. And how is our spikies coming along? Very nice. I like it. And here's the cobblestone rocks to fix our... broken decayed blocks. Excellent. This is gonna be looking good. I hope this is gonna end up looking good, because I really enjoy the look of the decayed brick. I just have to be careful not to upgrade this too much now, because it will turn into concrete. There we go. Nice. Love it. Oh, yes. And, oh, this is gonna look so awesome when this is done. Look at this. And then we're gonna have the torchlight everywhere. This is gonna be absolutely fantastic. Look at this, it's finished! The surface is covered, that is it, they're not getting through, that is absolutely fantastic. Now, of course, in the moment they can still dig into here, but hopefully they're not gonna get a reason to, because we're gonna be in the middle juggernating around here. So hopefully, maybe an explosion of a zombie will get through here, so we're gonna make sure we're gonna close everything off downstairs. And all the way around, it's supposed to look like that. Basically, this kind of thing that you see as an example is what's supposed to go all the way around when this is finished. And that way, we can go in and out, do everything we want. And what we might actually do is we might actually even build a bridge to go around, to go on top of it, either way. And the way we built the roof of the bridge will be in a way that they will fall down, that they slide down. So that should be amazing. I mean, oh man, I can't wait. This is gonna look absolutely fantastic. So let's start actually on these guys here to close them off. And we're gonna leave this open because we're gonna put all the spikes down now, all the way around. And we're gonna finish on the back end here, where we're gonna bring everything back around to the inside. This is gonna look fantastic. I don't think I have enough of those guys actually, but we'll see how many we need. I actually have no idea how many I'm counting upwards, so I better go and get my hay bales, so I'm gonna get back down. I'm just counting the number of pillars we have to put down. So I went 20 up, that's 21, 22, 23. So that's 23 pillars we're going up. Okay, so, okay, here we go. Woo! I love it. So that's 23, which means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 27 times 23. I'm not going to do that in my head, but that's basically how many we have to make. 27 times 23 plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, plus 8. Through the magic of editing, the number is 629. I just did that really fast in my head. Absolutely. No time lost at all. 629. So we're gonna make sure that we have another 400, and let's make it a little bit extra. So 440. We need to make another 440. Holy balls. Luckily, I made a lot more concrete mix, because we are really running low. Who would have known that it's taken so many resources? So while this is actually then in process, we're gonna put the spikes down. Excuse me, we're gonna put the spikes down. So let's do that. And we definitely should have enough spikes. And we can upgrade them all from below, which is fine. Oh, this is awesome. I love this so much, this design. This is gonna be fantastic. And the idea is obviously, see, 7 is too far. So if we're inside the shark cage, we won't be able to reach all the corpses over here. But the idea was at the time that I have all this thing going around done, which means we can just go underground, go over here, and then walk around everywhere and pick all the dead bodies, all the dead corpses up. So also, I just seen that I have a design thing in difference. This here, this block here, should actually be one of those blocks, but that would mean it's a little bit floaty looking over here. So if you look at here, the stone is actually floating. So that's probably why I had that. All right, yeah. So we're gonna see if we can replace that and put proper concrete blocks in there where these blocks are, because it looks more proper. I actually want the full concrete blocks in there. Wow, the spikes are actually taking quite some time to put down. I mean, they're easy enough to put down. You can nearly hold the finger down like without really clicking too much, but yeah, well, on the side here, we might actually have to be careful because it keeps putting them on top of each other otherwise, and then we have a problem. So, and I don't want to waste any if I don't have to. If we actually look at this, that is 200 and, say, approximately 450, approximately, 450 spikes. It's a little bit less than that. But each of them upgrades as well with, is it 40 or 80 iron? Like, I think it's 40 iron and then it goes to steel. Wow. So if we have only 40 iron, that's 450, that's 900. Wow, that's 4,500, 9,000, that's 18,000 iron just to upgrade them once, which is 36,000 iron if we upgrade them twice. And I think it's two upgrades. Holy balls, that is a lot of iron we're gonna need. Look at that spiky hedgehog. Oh, balls. That kind of went a bit weird looking. We're gonna take that out. We don't like this. We don't like your kind of triple double head here. Look at that. That is so cool. I mean, look at all the spikes. Look at around. Now let's jump up here. Let's go up. Look at that. A sea of spikes. Absolutely fantastic. And now we're gonna have to upgrade them all. And we actually want to also go up here and put down the actual pillars. So I think we can finish this wall here. So let's finish these guys here. And do not forget to remove the wood frame. You do that ever? Do not forget to remove the wood frame. Otherwise you break your bloody legs. We might actually be able to get away with doing this type of thing. And then just not pulling up. Yeah, excellent. Oh, I love it. This is gonna be actually taking so much less time because we had our resources really all prepared. And I made iron all the time, got it back out. I just didn't think we need that much. 36, I can't even say it, 36,000 still to go. Holy balls. We need 36,000 approximately, assuming we can upgrade them twice for 40 each. 36,000 iron. We have 10,000. Let's move that over. 20,000. And we have some here. Let's see if we get 25,000. Yeah. 10, 20, 30,000. And we have another couple of thousand queued up here. So we are gonna have the 36,000, no problem. And spare. Let's get the decayed brick and let's have a look. I finished the fish tank, I nearly said. I finished the shark tank now. And I also started, when I got up here on that side, over here, on the north side, I have to remember that that's north. I also started digging up the dirt a little bit to make a gap. We're gonna have to dig more, which means we're gonna have to put some jumpy things there. Some. Come on! Damn it! Some hay bales. Couldn't remember the What are you, Bales? Genie Mac! Hey, Bales here, so that we can start digging down here and even that out without the fear of falling, so which is gonna be great. So, yeah. Let's have a look about the upgrading. Let's finish the floor first, though, because if we can finish the floor first, I don't know if 60 is enough, but it sounded approximately right. So if we're gonna go here, I don't think 60 is enough. No, it's not gonna be, because we have already probably, we're using up 30 already just in this corner here. There we go. Yeah, look at that. We're already using up over 30 here in that little corner. Holy balls. When I kinda, you would think that after using, after building or placing thousands of blocks, that I would be better at estimating how many blocks per area is needed. So, wow. Okay, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, what is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 all the way across. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. That's 140. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's 140, 50, 60, 75. 175 minus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Minus 5. So 170. Wow. It's a lot more than I anticipated. Okay, so let's see if we can upgrade our junk from down here. So let's see, how many do we upgrade? One. Okay. And we actually should put the coat on. Wear that. And it's only one. Excellent. Then we can stop the presses, because we want to make steel instead then. We're slowly getting through all the iron, but we definitely have enough because they only upgraded once. We're just gonna keep going down, and the good thing about the nail gun is you can just hold it down. You don't have to worry about anything. Just keep following it. It's a little bit dizzying at times because you have to do the turning as well. And also, don't forget these guys. These guys, we might as well update them while we're there. That is why we have, after all the concrete mix on us. Very good. I like it. Now, I have to be very careful, though, with upgrading concrete, because once we get to steel, I don't want to upgrade the concrete to steel. I want to only upgrade the spikes to steel so that they don't straight away die like when somebody lands on it. So let me just finish this here. And then I think we are done down here, actually. Like, that we only have to do the floor then, and that's pretty much it. Awesome. Oh. There is so much to upgrade. I hope I don't forget anything, because I can just see myself now forgetting half of the spikes to be upgraded and then going, oh balls, when later on the horde is coming. Oh man. So we're just gonna spot check actually a couple of those guys. So we forgot actually a few of them, but we can reach them, it seems. I don't think, oh, there's one over there as well. Can I reach it? Oh, damn it. Okay, we're gonna have to get that from the bottom. So there's one there. The other ones we should be able to reach from the front here. There we go. And we can reach this one as well. Nice. How did I forget them? They look like they upgraded from underneath. Maybe not. I don't know. So we didn't forget any over here. Oh, there's another one. Oh, yes. It's the ones on the actual full solid blocks. Of course, because we can't see them from below. Okay, there. I forgot actually a few. Okay. Fair enough. We're going to have to come from the outside. End of story. Oh, this is close. Oh, hello. Might as well upgrade these guys. Thank you. We have to upgrade the first three anyway. And I made a lot of steel. Well, I made about 600 pieces of steel. So I don't remember, actually. I think we need 10 per upgrade. And it's the first three that I want to upgrade. The frames are all over the shop right now. And I don't know why. I think it's because all the concrete is drying. So I'm gonna wrap this episode up here and let that dry. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you're gonna enjoy, I hope you did enjoy the episode. And if you did, remember to kick that like button in the balls. And I hope I see you guys in the next episode. And if you're new to the channel and you like what you see, hit that subscribe button. And I see you guys next time. Until then, as always, viel Spaß and happy gaming. This is gonna take some time. Okay, next set. Nice. I them all done before 10 o'clock, and then we're having waffles for breakfast. Oh yeah. Nice.